Hello and welcome to Digital Gouache. My name is Chucky and today we're going to look at how to make a collage in Photoshop Elements. Now I'm using Photoshop Elements 9. There's a great new feature that you can use that is the layer masking tool. Now we're going to use that a lot today. I have lots of photos that are already open. A couple different ways that you can open them. You can open them through the organizer, or in my case I can just go to the top where it says File, and then I just select Open, and then what I do is I normally just pick all of the files that I want to open and use the Command or Control key, depending upon if you have a Mac or a PC, and then I select Open, and what it'll do is it will open all the different files and then put them in the bin at the bottom. Now on the right hand side at the top here, it tells you which one of the files that you're working on. You can see that I'm working on this one, and if you're wondering where I got this really nice batch of leaves that I'm using today, that is in the backgrounds. If you don't see the backgrounds right here, normally you have the effects tab up here. Right next to the effects tab is the content tab, and then you can choose by type and then backgrounds, and then I just picked this one right here and selected it, and then it put it as my background. Now the next thing that we're going to do is, once you have all these photos here, now I took a couple of these pictures and then some of these are Linolfian. As you can see, I'm giving credit for the Creative Commons license. It lets me use Linolfian, lets me use his photos there. It does a great job. This is Model Photography Calgary, and the last one is the Code Poet. Now if you want to use theirs or check them out, go to the Creative Commons and you can type in Code Poet Linolfian or Model Photography Calgary, and you can get those photos over there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to put all the pictures on one photo in different layers. Now in order for this to work, you must have them all in one canvas. So I'm going to use the Move tool, which is the top left tool right up here. This is the new Move tool. I'm going to grab these photos and I'm just going to drag them onto my canvas or my palette. So you can see I click that, it turns this blue, and I'm going to grab it and I'm going to drag it on top of the photo. And as you can see right here in my layers palette, there's my background, and it dropped the photo in a new layer right here. Now this picture of the giraffe, I'm going to grab it and I'm going to drop it onto my photo. Then I'm going to drag these pictures of Linolfian's model here. I'm going to drag all these, and then last but not least, I'm going to take the Code Poet, and then I'm going to do that. Now as you can see, let me grab this layers palette so you can see it a little bit better. As you can see here, each one of those photos was brought into my original as a new layer. Now you can see the bounding box. This is called a bounding box, and you can see the little handles. Now you can resize these photos and then you can turn them by holding a little bit away from the corner, and you can drag and kind of move these around wherever you want them in your photo. So what I want you to do now is I want you to click on each one of the photos that you drug in, and then what I want you to do is I want you to place them somewhere on your screen, kind of like a collage here. So as we can see, and let me kind of move some of these around. I'm going to twist and turn them a little bit. Twist and turn them just a slight bit, kind of make a collage out of it. And just keep going here. Now the giraffe one, I'm going to have to move that around somewhere here. Okay, you can see that I'm moving it just off the corner a little bit so that it gets that weird looking arrow thing, and then I'm moving this around, and then once I'm happy with where the photo is, I hit the Enter key so that I can move the next one. Now once again, this giraffe photo is rather large, so I need to look. There's the corner of it. I'm just going to make that a little bit smaller. There we go. Just keep making it smaller. And last but not least, I can hold my mouse right over the corner. It turns into the little corner thing, and then I can twist my giraffe picture, and then once I'm in a place where I like it, I hit the Enter key, And last but not least is this last picture of a model down here. Now, it's not perfect right now, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to go in here and use this new icon that you have in your layer palette called a layer mask. So I'm going to start up at the top here. I'm going to select that layer right here, and then I'm going to use a layer mask. Now, what the layer mask does is it hides a portion of this photo right here. Now, I can take the gradient tool, which is right here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that it's a black and white, and I am going to paint black and white onto this layer mask and watch what happens when I do that. I'm going to draw a line there, and I did it the wrong way. Of course, it's always nice to make mistakes on your YouTube videos. I'm going to use the Control Z. We have to make sure that the white is in the foreground and the black is in the background. Make sure that our layer mask is selected. Start from the center here and go to the outside. And as you can see, wherever it is white, you can see the photo. And wherever it's black, it's going to mask it away. Now, I could go right again if I didn't like this, and I could make another little line right here, maybe a little bit longer. You can see a little bit more of that with the edges. So as you can see, she's kind of blending in with some of the leaves here. Now I'm going to go to my next one, do the same thing. I'm going to add a layer mask, and with the gradient selected here, making sure that you have white in the foreground and black in the background, you can do the same thing again. A little bit too much on the blending. I'll try that again. There we go. And I will continue to do that, making new layer masks on each one of these until these all kind of blend in like a collage. And I need to make these a little bit larger there. Go to the next layer, add a layer mask. Now you can do this with anything. You could, if you wanted to, you could just paint black and white on there, and it would also blend it. Let me change this from the circular gradient, and I'll just use a linear gradient going from top to bottom and show you what that looks like. I'm going to add a layer mask here. I'm going to go from top to bottom, and as you can see part of the photo here and not the other part. Let's swap these around, and let's take a look and see what that looks like there. Now, as you can see, that is a linear gradient, so it is blending from one to the other. And then last but not least, I'm going to show you how to do it on this model Calgary, Photo Photography Calgary. But this time I'm going to use our marching ants. You can actually select something with your lasso tool here. I'm going to make a selection around her face like this. And I want to make it kind of wavy, as you can see right there. And then I'm going to go over here where it says select, and I'm going to feather the selection just a little bit, 5 pixels. And then I'm going to select my layer mask tool and watch what happens. Look at that. And as you can see, it masked everything that was outside of this. Go ahead and revert this to the original photo, because now I'm going to show you from the very beginning how I did this. I started with just any old picture. I added a background, and it's going to make this these leaves my background. Then I drug all these photos in here. Now this time what I'm going to do is I'm just going to place these and move these one at a time as I bring them in. If I'm happy with that, I'm going to hit return, drag this one in there, resize this one as best I can, and place it somewhere and spin it around a little bit and hit enter. Drag this photo in there, move it down here, spin it around a little bit, hit enter. Drag this photo in here, and maybe I don't even want to spin that one. I'll just put that one in the middle. Drag another one over here and spin this one around just a little bit. Move this one over here because we're going to blend that one. Hit enter. And last but not least, drag this photo down here, and that should be good right about there. Now I'm going to show you the second method that I used. Each one of these photos I'm going to draw with the lasso tool. I'm going to draw something with the lasso tool right here, just kind of like that. I'm going to draw that with the lasso tool. You want to make sure that you select and you feather it just a little bit. Maybe 5 pixels isn't enough, so maybe you can up that to about 20 pixels. And then when you're happy with it, you hit this add layer mask, and as you can see, it kind of blended that in there. So I'm going to go to the next one, which is this one right here. I'm going to draw kind of a wavy little lasso around that. I'm going to go to select, feather that one 20 pixels, and then I'm going to hit the layer mask on that one, and there we go. And a little bit over here, just kind of, there we go. And once again, feather that, select OK, hit layer mask on that one, go over here, oh, I actually brought that in twice, so, oh, no I didn't. Okay, draw a little one around here, there we go, and select, feather. As you can see, it's very easy, and you can make some really great collages. You can also move these around with your move tool if you're not happy with where they're at. Let's go ahead and draw something. So there's a couple different ways. If you just want a simple looking gradient with it, you can just paint with black and white. If you want to actually do some drawing around there and then hit the layer mask icon, you can do that. That's what happens when you do not put a feather. You see those nice sharp edges, so let's go ahead and do Command Z there, select, let's feather those edges just a little bit, and then add the layer mask, and there we go. And last but not least, here we go with our model here from Calgary, and select, feather, okay, and layer mask. So there we go. There we have it. Now, of course, you can do a much better job. You can put lots more photos in there. You can tweak them around, use the move tool. You can keep spinning these things around, putting them in place. But I would probably start with kind of a nice looking background here. Photoshop's got some great ones with these leaves. They've got maps in here and different things. So I hope that has helped. You can create a great looking collage there, and using the new layer masking tool in Photoshop Elements, I think you'll have a really great time. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so. Leave me a message. Give me a thumbs up. This is Chucky from Digital Goulash. Thanks. Have a great day.